our identity as Muslims, our religion, our culture, our faith, and our practices in a positive, balanced, and moderate way. That is the vision of MAC. MAC, as part of that mission, is partnered with many, many organizations. Some of them are Muslim organizations, some of them are not Muslim organizations, but they share similar values and are working towards causes that are valuable to Muslims as well, such as the Daily Bread Food Bank, the Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation, the Children AIDS Society, Islamic Relief, Irfan Canada, the International Relief Fund for the Afflicted and Needy, Habitat for Humanity, and the list goes on and on. MAC currently has a national presence with operations in over 11 major Canadian cities across the country. So, a few of the local highlights of what MAC has accomplished in recent years, let me start with some of the schools. Most of you may have heard of Olive Grove School. Olive Grove is a full-time elementary Islamic school from junior kindergarten all the way up to grade 8. In the last few years, Olive Grove has been operating. The enrollment has grown from only 85 students to, mashallah, over 500 students. Al-Huda is a weekend Islamic school focusing on Quran, Arabic, and Islamic studies. It's completely not just for Arabs, it's not just for Pakistanis, it's not for Somalis, it's for Muslims, and it's open, the doors are open to anybody in the Islamic community who wants to benefit from it. There are 4 locations right now in the GTA, Ajax, Hilton, and 2 locations in Mississauga. Some of the programs that we run for youth, you may have heard of Myathlon, which actually started with our sister organization in the USA, MASS, Muslim American Society. It's an annual athletic competition for youth. Everything from soccer to basketball to badminton and some non-athletic events as well, like poetry and skits, and it's massive. There are high school students all over the country participating in this, and I encourage you to look into it. You may have heard of the Iman Rewards Night. It's a large rewards night for school students who have strong academic performance. And we've had over 500, you know, in the audience to honor these young Muslims for their accomplishment, including respected government dignitaries, members of academia, public and private school board members, members of various religious and cultural organizations, and of course the families and other students. So it's a great way to show our youth that we as Muslims value education, and we value being excellent at what we do, and we value high academic performance. So that is another program for youth that MAC organizes and runs effectively. Over 300 Muslim youth were recognized for their achievements last year alone. Some of the educational programs that MAC is organizing and running, we have an After Shahada Revert Muslim Support Group, which is just what it says, a support group for new Muslims based on the premise that they require additional support and encouragement in learning and culturing so they become healthy, active contributors to the Muslim community in a positive way and don't change their mind in reverse. So their experience coming into our community is a positive one. Rather than just focusing on education, it's also designed to help them overcome some of the personal challenges and to meet other people who have a similar experience to help them get over that. Of course, we have the community programs like this one. This is probably the largest one, our Eid Festival. This is the 28th annual Eid Festival in the GTA. Takbir! Inshallah. Volunteers and workers of MAC are behind this. They work day and night, planning months, sometimes a year in advance, to book the hall, to organize the advertising, to coordinate the media, to manage the facilities, the logistics, working all night. Even the cardboard mats that you're sitting on, our delivery didn't come in last night, so some of these brothers, mashallah, since last night, were scrambling to find a company that would provide that, just so that the community could have a nice, comfortable place to sit other than just the cement floor. So, alhamdulillah, this is the level of commitment of some of these workers. Some of the institutions, you may know Masjid Toronto downtown. It's arguably the most established Islamic center in the downtown core. There are hundreds if not thousands of Muslims in the downtown core who benefit from that masjid. On Jummah, even though there's three different Jummah services, it's not uncommon for the Jummah attendees to spill right out onto the streets to pray. So recently we purchased another center downtown, Masjid Adelaide. If you have that chance, I encourage you to go and visit that masjid and check it out. We're currently in process of establishing the staff for this new masjid, some new imams, leaders of the community. Remember again, Eid is a time for festivities. Our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam made it a day of festivities. We don't fast on this day, we celebrate. We celebrate, mashallah, it's so good to see everyone here, so many people benefiting from it. Look at all the young children, look at the experience, think about it. Think about the experience that they're having and how that's going to last them for the rest of their lives. How they're going to grow up really feeling that this is my community. When I was growing up, we had nothing like this. Just two rakats and a khutbah in the masjid and everybody would go home. Here we have an entire day until 6 p.m. where the children can meet each other, can feel like part of this community, can see thousands, 10 to 20,000 Muslims all in one place, organized, praying together as one community. It's a beautiful thing. We need to support it. Please, my brothers and sisters, donate to it. If you already donated, consider donating more. The cardboard boxes are all around. There are volunteers going in and out of the aisles with the donation boxes. Support it. It's a good cause, inshallah. It's not an unworthy cause. So the prayer, inshallah, we're going to start really soon in a few minutes. I believe our khatib is here. It's in 5 minutes, inshallah. So just about the carnival, it'll start at 11 o'clock. The second khutbah will also start at 11 o'clock. If you want to purchase a wristband for your child, you can do it back at the bazaar. If they're 4 years old or older, it's $15 for an all-day pass. If they're 3 years old or younger, it's only $8 to get their wristband. Both the parent and the child must be present when purchasing the wristband. When you get your wristband, parents, please write with the pen your phone number on the inside of the wristband. We get at least a dozen to two dozen lost children throughout the day at Eid. We'd like to give the children a positive experience, so if you can write your phone number, it'll be a much easier way to reach you than having to drag the child to the stage and call your name out. So we're going to continue with the takbirat. My dear brother Fahad has a few things to say, and then he's going to lead us in the takbirat for the prayer.